Good morning, students. Today we are going to study the last topic of our chapter number 4, that is banking and monetary policy. Till now we have covered up the topics like evolution and the meaning of banks, classification of bank in that commercial bank related to its functions, presence of commercial banks in India, and the central bank, that is the Reserve Bank of India, and its various functions. Now today we are going to see regarding the monetary policies and the instrument of the monetary policies made. So the first today, that is what is monetary policy, we need to identify. Now you can see the first point, students. Monetary policy is the policy which regulates the demand for money and the supply of money in the economy. So whatever the regulation work we can say, or the supply of money in the economy as per the demands, we can say. So nature of money we can talk about, or the value of money we can talk about, volume of the money we can talk about. These all are the main purpose of the monetary policy. Now monetary policy, main function of the RBI, that they are managing the demand and supply, that is inflow and outflow of cash is monitored and managed by RBI itself, we can say such. Now you can see the second also, the inflation deflation point can impact the value of Indian currency. Hence this policy is also known as one of the stabilization policy. What it means, that value of rupee whether is going to be up or down, just because of the monetary policy, this is also going to be say as stabilization policy. So that regulation and managing work is also done by monetary policies. Now third point, you can see that the policy which entrench the various tools of the regulating the supply of money in the hands of the apex bank, that is our RBI, with the purpose of achieving the general economic objectives is called the monetary policies. Now here these tools, that is the monetary policies, is tools can are regulating purpose for the supply and demand, we can say, to control the inflation or deflation, we can say outflow inflow of the cash, we can say. So all these things are managed, but the main purpose over here is achieving the various economic objectives. So that's why this monetary policy is quite useful. Now the various tools we are going to see today, they are like, so students, you can see that instruments of the monetary policies, in that quantitative measures, that is the general measures, and the qualitative measures, that is the special measures we are going to see. Now in the quantitative measures, that is the bank rate, repo rate, reverse repo rate, marginal standing facilities, cash reserve ratios, statutory liquidity ratios, and the open market operations in the quantitative measures. Now as we come to the qualitative measures, then it will be the security requirement is there, margin requirement is there, ceiling credit, and the discriminatory interest rate. So these are the topics we are going to see in the detail. And here the repo rate and the reverse repo rate, both are very much important from the viewpoint of your exams also. It can be asked for the 2 marks, what is reverse repo rate and what is repo rate. Now the very first is the bank rate. Now what is bank rate, we need to understand, students, first that when the commercial bank have the shortage of funds and they borrow it from the RBI. Now wherever the commercial banks need the funds, as they are having the shortage of funds, they will borrow it from the RBI. Now the main thing is the rate at which RBI is lending to the commercial bank, and that also for the long period of time, that is going to be termed as a bank rate. Now here the circumstances arises that if the bank rate is increased, now what will happen, the commercial bank will borrow the less, as because it is expensive. Now when the commercial bank is borrowing the lesser amount and at a higher rate, now what will happen, they give the lesser amount of loan to the public, and that too also at a higher rate. Now the people are getting the fewer loans, then the demand for certain goods and services falls down. Now as the demands of goods and services falls down, the creation of the money, we can say, or the supply of money in the market also goes down. So, when the economy is under the grip of inflation, bank rate is increased to control the inflation. So, whenever there is an inflation, we can say for controlling that, the bank rate is increased to an extent. So, this point should be kept in mind. Then, another thing we need to remember in this is when the supply of money is higher. So, there is a flow of money in the market, we can see. And then the demand for money, there is an inflation, we can say. Because then whenever there is a supply of money or the creation of money is higher than the demand for money, there is an inflation over there. And hence, reducing the money supply then helps in the reducing the inflation. And if another thing is, and if the supply of money is lower than the demand of money, there will be a depression in that period. Now another thing you can see on your screen, students, that is the fourth line. When bank rate is very low, it is called as a cheap money policy, and when the bank rates are higher than, is called as a dear money policy. That if the bank rate is 4 to 6%, then it will be a cheap money policy, and if the bank rate are 10 to 12%, then we can term it as a dear money policy. As right now we are assuming the bank rate as a 8%. But students, what is happening that RBI has already stopped using the bank rate as an instrument to regulate the money supply, because since the last many years it is using the repo rate and reverse repo rate. Because bank rate is a rate, we can say, as for a long period of time, taken for the long term, and that cannot be changed in a very short period of time. That's why repo and reverse repo rate can be altered in a very short duration or period. So they help to regulate the money supply in the short term. That's why the RBI has stopped using the bank rate as an instrument to regulate the money supply in the market. So these are the points you should take into consideration while writing the bank rate. And you can write as an example, which is given in your textbook also, that's year and bank rate. 1953 it is 3.5, in 1981 it is 10, and then 1991 it is 12, then suddenly in the 2016 it is 7. So like these examples you can able to write, but this also changes accordingly. Now the second one we are going to see is the repo rate. This is the important one. Now here, students, you need to remember the first point. You can see that when the commercial bank need funds for the very short period of time, that is for the 1 day their requirement is there, or 7 day, or the 15 day, so that is called as a repo rate. But here they sell some of the securities which are held by them to the RBI. But they also made an agreement of the repurchase and at a particular rate. So, but here bank sells government security to the RBI. That government security, here we can take the example of the treasury bill. Now treasury bill as a security issued by the government of India, as a promissory note with the guaranteed repayment at a later date. Fund collected through such that are used to meet the short-term funds are called the treasury bills. The treasury bills can also be for the 91 days, 182 days, and the 364 days. Here bank sells the government security to the RBI. That government security, in that we can take the example of treasury bills. Now, for what purpose? In order to raise out the money for a very short period of time, but here with the condition to repurchase them at some discount. So this is also called, the repo is also called as a repurchase rate, we can say. Now what will happen if the event of the inflation arises? Now the RBI increases the repo rate, then what happened? This will act as a disincentive for the banks to borrow from the RBI. Now the banks will lend the general public at a higher rate. Ultimately the people borrowing the less, and that money, we can say that money supply, thus the money supply and the inflation are maintained over it. So accordingly the vice versa, if there is a deflation, we can say, or the RBI decreases
the repo rate. So it is a vice versa of the inflation. So you just need to remember that the commercial bank need fund for the very short period of time. The time period you must remember 1 day, 7 days, 15 days, as accordingly sell some securities. In security treasury bill you can write it is for the 91 days, 182 days and 364 days. Now there must be a repurchase agreement at some discount you need to write out, and the inflation and the deflation point also, what the reaction will be if there is RBI increases the repo rate and RBI decreases the repo rate accordingly. Now the third one we are going to do. Now the third one is the reverse repo rate. Now what will happen in the reverse repo rate? Now here the RBI has to borrow the short term funds from the commercial bank, but by parking its own securities with the commercial bank, we can say. As what is written, you can see on your screen that reverse repo rate means the agreed upon rate at which the RBI repurchases its security from the commercial bank in the event when RBI has to borrow the short term funds from the commercial bank by parking its securities with the commercial bank, you can say. So here the RBI is borrowing short term funds from the commercial bank, but now RBI sells its government securities held by it to the commercial bank. Here also applying the condition of repurchasing at a discount rate at the end of the short period of time, we can say. Now here the also the situation arises, what will happen when there is an increase in the repo rate? Then the commercial bank will going to get the more incentives to park their funds with the RBI. So by lending more to the RBI, then the commercial bank receiving the more incentive by parking their funds, then what will happen? The bank will decrease their lending to the general public, we can say, and ultimately the supply of money is reduces, and the supply of money in the market reduced to an extent. So the vice versa when there is a decrease in the reverse repo rate, we can say. So you need to remember, students, here the points related to the RBI is borrowing short term funds from the commercial bank, but by parking its security with the commercial bank, and the both increase in the reverse repo rate, what will happen, and the decrease in the reverse repo rate, what will happen. So this should be kept in the mind very much carefully. So repo rate and reverse repo rate, we can say it as a both are the very important points. Now the fourth one you can see, students, is the marginal standing facility, or we can say it as a stabilization under the emergency situation. Now what will happen over here? We can say it as a special type of window for the all the banks, we can say, to borrow the fund from the RBI as and when required, or where there is a shortage, cash shortage, we can say specially. So whenever there is a cash shortage, the RBI can give the loans to the banks. So whenever there is a need of the or the shortage of funds, the banks can borrow from the RBI, the special window we can say it as. But here we can say as the there is a higher rate as compared to the repo rate. If the in the repo rate there is a 6% is there, then here maybe 6.5 or 7% will be there. So the rates are normally higher than the repo rate, we can say. That what it is written in your in the point, there is a special window for the bank to borrow from the RBI against the approved government security in the emergency situations like cash shortage. So whenever there is a cash shortage, the banks can borrow it from the RBI, but here also there against approved government security only. You need to keep the approved government security, then only RBI will lend the money to the banks. So this is the marginal standing facility, we can say it as. Now the another one is the cash reserve ratio. Now here you can see, students, in the very first line, that is under the RBI Act 1934, all the commercial bank have to keep certain cash reserve with the RBI. As when such what happened, that cash reserve ratio is going to fulfill the needs of the comfortable amount of the cash reserves with the banking system taking place. Now in case suddenly happens that many customers continuously start withdrawing their deposit,
Now bank have to provide the cash against their deposit. So there must be the cash reserve with the RBI. So that's why CRR is capped. You can say it as, and cash reserve ratio was decided to be 5% of the demand deposit. Demand deposit matlab current and saving account students, and 2% of the time deposit that is on the fixed. So that must be over here is a variable according to the requirement felt by the RBI. Since from the 1962 after that, the CRR, that is the cash reserve ratios, is variable between 3% and 15%, we can say, of the total deposit of the individual in each bank, we can say. But right now we can say it as a CRR is 3%. So it's variables between the 3 to 15%. Now here also the points arises of the to control the inflation. Then we can say it as, when the cash reserve ratio is higher, the commercial bank have the lesser deposit money here with them to create a credit facility. Now they will, what will do, they do that, they are going to do give the fewer loans to the people, and hence we can say it as money supply and inflation are curtailed. Vice versa, the CRR is reduced in the time of depression, and we also can say it as a deflation. So here you need to keep in mind that the commercial bank need to keep certain cash reserves with the RBI. There 5% for the demand deposit, 2% for the time deposit. There were as according to requirement fell, it is changed in 1962. It is variable between the 3 and 15%, you need to remember. This is why suddenly the customers start withdrawing their deposit. Now the bank also need certain cash against their deposit to pay to them, to each and every customers. So there must be a cash reserve ratio with them. Now here the points also regarding the inflation and deflation you need to be remember. So accordingly, this is a cash reserve ratio. Then the next one is the statutory liquidity ratio. Now here the statutory liquidity ratio. The statutory liquidity means it is the compulsory and mandatory, you have to maintain this much liquid into your business, we can say as a bank. So there must be certain cash into your bank, we can say as. Main thing you should remember, students, in the statutory liquidity ratio, that the it can be preserved in the form of the cash, gold, but before credit, providing the credit to their own customers. Now here also you can see on the screen, under the Banking Regulation Act 1949, all the banks have to maintain equal to and less than 25% of their total deposit, and here also it includes demand and time. Now demand for the current and saving, and the time deposit for the time for the fixed deposits. So there must be maintained an equal to or less than 25% as a total, or that is overall deposit, in the form of cash, gold and the approved securities with your bank itself, not with the RBI. Here one thing you should remember, students, that it is not with the RBI, but it is with the bank itself. This securities, we can say cash or gold, it is whichever is there, it is kept with the bank, not with the RBI one. So almost we can say it as, there is a 30% amount is safe with the RBI and the commercial bank, and the rest amount is used for the lending purpose. Now if the RBI increases the SLR, that is the statutory liquidity ratio, when bank is having the more deposit money. Now the vice versa, whenever the RBI decreases the statutory liquidity ratio, when the bank is having the less deposit money with them. So this is arises at a time of inflations. Now one more thing, whenever there is a increase in the rupees, then the bank rate of the interest is going to be decreased by the RBI. We can say it as, when the RBI increases SLR, less funds are available with the bank, as they have to keep the large portion of their cash in hand with the RBI. Now when the RBI decreases the SLR, the more funds are available with the bank,
as they have to keep the smaller portions of their cash in hand with the RBI. So these are the points to be kept in mind, students. These are the whether it is a cash, gold and approved securities, it is with the bank, is kept with and not with the RBI. It is must be equal to or less than 25% of the demand and time deposit both. There is a total deposit, we can say it as. Which type of security? There is a cash, gold and government securities. Then the 30% we can say it is in the safely with the RBI and commercial bank. And then we have to write the regarding the when it is RBI increases the SLR and RBI decreases the SLR. And what will happen? Well, RBI increases the SLR and when the RBI decreases the SLR. So these are the points to be kept in mind in the statutory liquidity ratio. Now the seventh one, that is the open market operation, students. Now here we can talk it about between, is it between the RBI and the individuals, not with the RBI with the banks, we can say it as. You can see on the screen that is open market operations refers to the sale of or purchase of government securities, bonds by the RBI in the market. Now here any individual who have the demat account, they can purchase the open market operation. That means the securities and bond, we can see. Now benefit of this is as RBI is taking the security. Example, if I want to take the treasury bill, so I have to buy from the open market operation. And although this instrument is issued from the 1991, before this is not applicable. And we can purchase it from the website of the RBI starting from 10,000 price, then 1,000 more, that is 11,000, then 12,000. So you can purchase any of them. Now what we have to do, we have to purchase that how they are, we have to purchase. And then main is the how they are managing the cash with the help of this. That is the question mark. Example, we can take that they were selling their security. So they were selling their securities to the market. Now we have to give the 10,000 rupees to the RBI. And now RBI will give the money in cases of the inflation arises. They will declare the open market operation, so more money from the market can be collected by the RBI and RBI give the security. So this is what, students, we are going to learn in the open market operations. And the must major is the referring to the sale or the purchase of the government bonds and securities by the RBI, we can see, and that too in the open market. So this is the point you should taken into the considerations. So these are the four quantitative measures we are going to learn in the monetary policy. The qualitative measures we are going to learn in the, see in the another session. Thank you and have a nice day.